Hello students, now we will start with the lesson microorganisms. And for that, first of all, we have to understand what is microorganism. The organisms that are visible only through the microscope are called as microorganism. So a microscope is needed for seeing the smaller objects. And when we see through the microscope, the smaller objects appear larger. So usually what we use in our classes or what we use in the laboratory situation is the compound microscope, and this has to be used for viewing the objects that are very very small that we can't see with our naked eyes. So for that we have to use what? Microscope. So what is a microscope? This is an instrument, and there are lenses. So lenses, they used to actually magnify the size of the smaller objects. So microscope is an instrument that makes the use of lenses so that the size of the very smaller particles or very smaller objects appear larger. So what we use actually the compound microscope. Now the things that we have to see is called the object, whatever cell or whatever we want to see, that is which are very small particles, can be called as objects, and they can be kept on a glass sheet that is called as slide. A piece of glass that is called a slide for the microscope. And another one is called the cover slip. So first of all we have to take a slide, and then over that we keep the object and then cover the object with the help of a cover slip. So what does this cover slip do? This cover slip will protect. And what it will protect? The microscope lens. So it will not come in contact with the object that we are seeing under microscope. So we have to use the cover slip while viewing under microscope to prevent any damage to the lens, and lens will not come in contact with the object that we want to see under the microscope. So what it will protect? Protect the lenses of the microscope. So see, microscope helps in enlarging the size of the objects that we want to see. Now, what are the basic steps that we should use for handling the microscope? So we have to clean the mirror as and when required. Then we have to place the slide on the stage, and then we have to adjust the focus of the eyepiece and objective lens with the help of the teacher, obviously, and we have to view the slide through the eyepiece. So now I'll show you the picture of the microscope. If you can see here, this is the eyepiece lens through which we can see, and the adjustment lenses are also here. The bigger one here, this is coarse adjustment screw, this is screw, these are lenses, and this is a fine adjustment, and here the lenses, there are different powers given in the lenses, like 45x or 10x, and this x denotes how many times the magnification is done when we see through the eyepiece over here. This is the stage where we keep the slide, and this is the mirror. These are all the parts of the microscope which allows the light to go and reflect, and then we get the view here through the eyepiece lens. So see, eyepiece, then there is coarse adjustment, there is fine adjustment, these are the side screws, and the lenses with having different magnitudes, 10x, 45x, like this, and this is the stage where we keep the slide with the cover slip. This is the mirror, this is the base, and this is the handle which we should hold while taking the microscope from one place to another, because this is very costly, and if we don't handle it with care, then it may damage, it may fall, and it may break. So now we come to the types of microorganisms. So what are the microorganisms? Microorganisms are those that are not visible in our naked eye, so we have to see it under a microscope. So if you have to see it under a microscope, then those organisms are called as microorganisms or microbes. So they are the most abundant organisms on the planet. They are found everywhere. They are found even in the hot springs. They are found in the ice. They are found in the polar regions. Everywhere microorganisms can be found. And some can live alone and some can live in colonies, that is groups. So colony means group. Suppose this is one, like this way, they can stay in group. So this is called as a colony. So microorganisms are very small organisms found everywhere on earth, and they can be found in colonies. They can be living alone also. They may be unicellular, they may be multicellular, and they can be divided into five groups, that is bacteria, protozoa, fungi, algae and viruses. So bacteria, protozoa, fungi and viruses are the five types of microorganisms. Bacteria, as you all know, these are found everywhere in and around us, and they also are harmful, they also are useful. Protozoa also, they are single-celled organisms. Fungi, including mushroom, mushrooms is multicellular, but other fungi are unicellular. Mushroom, toadstool, these are multicellular. Other fungi are unicellular. Algae includes seaweed and also viruses. So see, next we come to bacteria, which are unicellular. As you all know, they can be of various shapes, like rod shape, spherical, comma and spiral shape. Rod shape is like this, spherical, cocci, comma shaped, vibrio, and spiral is spirilla, that is spiral shape, like this. So these are the four types of bacteria having different shapes: rod shape, spherical, comma and spirilla, that is spiral. And examples of bacteria, there is Lactobacillus and Streptococcus. There are millions other, like E. coli, and different other bacteria are also there. But two names are given here, Lactobacillus and Streptococcus. Now, protozoa, this is another group of animals, like unicellular organism. They are unicellular, so they are named as protozoa, but they are animal-like. Amoeba, Paramecium, Euglena are examples. Next is fungi, which are unicellular or multicellular. They don't have chlorophyll, and they take their nutrition from the dead decaying matter. Now, yeast is an example of unicellular fungi, but others may be multicellular, like mushroom and toadstools, but they don't have chlorophyll, so they have their nutrition from different sources, like dead bodies or somewhere else. Now, algae, these are plant-like, and they have chlorophyll. They are unicellular or multicellular. Now, unicellular algae are chlamydomonas, and multicellular is seaweeds. So before only I told that they can be unicellular or multicellular. So for multicellular we have seaweeds, and unicellular we have chlamydomonas. And then come the most deadly, or we can say the most confusing type, is the viruses, which are visible through electron microscopes only. They are not visible under the compound microscope. They are visible under electron microscopes only. So they are very crucial. They are confusing because we cannot identify them as living or non-living. But when they grow inside the cells, when they go inside any body, any host body, any living body, then they multiply there, they reproduce. And the number of cells increase inside the organisms. So example of this virus is, already you know what is the pandemic situation. So there you can give the examples of coronavirus, and then HIV, that is human immunodeficiency virus, tobacco mosaic virus for the plants. So previously we used to fear about swine flu and bird flu, and now there is the situation which is called as COVID-19. So all these are because of the viruses, which are very, very deadly, and simply we cannot control the viruses because they don't have their own life pattern. But when they enter the living bodies, there they multiply, and there they behave like the body where they have gone inside. To whose body it has gone, there they behave like the body cells itself. So there lies the problem with the viruses. So now what we have studied here is bacteria, protozoa, fungi and algae. Try to just analyze that. Bacteria unicellular, protozoa unicellular, animal like, fungi may be unicellular, multicellular, algae they can be unicellular, multicellular, and viruses. We cannot categorize them as living and non-living. Now, there are different uses of bacteria. That first of all is commercial uses. Commercial means which is used commercially for selling, for earning money, or for consumption. So, making curd and cheese, alcoholic beverages, bread, vinegar, coffee, tobacco, and toothpaste. So, various uses are there for the microorganisms. And we are now studying about the commercial uses. Now we will start with how to make curd. Now, curd can be made at home also, and for that you need a little bit of curd, and then you put it in the warm milk and leave it overnight. Then in the morning you can see the milk has turned into curd. Why this milk has turned into curd? Because the casein that is present in the milk, that coagulates to form the curd. Coagulates means accumulate together, become thick, and become solidified. So that is called coagulation. So when you give 1 teaspoon of curd into the milk, which is slightly warm, then it can coagulate and form curd by overnight. So milk is having a protein that is called as casein. Now the milk has to be acidic, so casein will coagulate in the acidic medium. So milk has to be made into acidic. So lactobacillus that is present in the spoon of curd, when it is added to the milk, this changes the sugar of the milk into the acid, which is lactic acid. So this creates the acidic environment, and then casein coagulates, right? So see, the situation is like that. The protein is present in the milk, which is called as casein, and this has to coagulate to form curd. So who will do this? We'll have to add some acidic medium into the milk so that the casein can coagulate. So what can be done? 1 teaspoon of previously made curd can be added to the warm milk, where we can see the and lactobacillus that is present in the previously added spoon of curd converts the sugar, that is the lactose sugar present in the milk, into acidic form. So then it leads to the coagulation of the casein. So this process of conversion of sugar into acid or alcohol, it can be converted to acid. Here in milk it is acid, but somewhere else it can form alcohol also. So the same process is called as fermentation, where sugar is converted into acid or alcohol. So that is called as fermentation. Similarly, for making cheese, the people who make cheese use a substance from the stomach of the young cattle that is called as rennet. So this is used to the milk to make the process faster. And addition of rennet results in the formation of the lactic acid again, and then helps in the process of formation of the cheese very easily. Then making alcoholic beverages, this is also very important. The alcohol drinks that people drink are called the beverages. So there are beers, wine, and these all are produced by the fermentation of different products like barley, grapes, and other fruits by a fungus which is called the yeast. And the process is fermentation, where the sugar part of the food is converted into either acid or alcohol. So here it is alcoholic beverage. So it is converted into alcohol and carbon dioxide. So for making bread also, if you can see, the yeast is used, and by kneading a mixture of flour, salt, sugar, yeast cells, and then giving water, make it into a dough. After some time, the volume of the dough increases, and they can be baked at about more than 180 degrees centigrade. So then baking is done. By that time, the yeast is also killed, and there's no fermentation Alcohol evaporates during the baking process and the whole set of work is completed very easily. So while making bread and other bakery products, the fermentation is done by the help of the yeast, which is the baker's yeast and which converts the sugar to alcohol and carbon dioxide. And when more and more carbon dioxide is produced, the volume of the dough rises up. Then it can be baked and the yeast can be killed. The alcohol evaporates and this way a baked material is ready. Now, bacteria is also used for making vinegar, tea, coffee, tobacco. Tea, coffee, tobacco needs processing. For processing, this bacteria can be used. Therefore, making toothpaste, type of algae which is called diatoms can be used. And xanthan gum is also obtained from bacteria. Xanthomonas campestris, this is also used for making the toothpaste. So, see, we have studied now about different uses of microorganisms commercial uses. Now, we'll study about the medicinal uses. As you can see here, antibiotics, which are used for killing the bacteria which causes diseases. So, if we suffer from any bacterial disease, then doctor prescribes us with antibiotics, which are used for the for stopping the life cycle of the bacteria. So after the proper dose, we are cured from the disease. So for that, antibiotics are used, and this is mainly for bacteria. And the first ever bacteria obtained was penicillin, which was made from the fungus Penicillium. Similarly, different other antibiotics are there, like streptomycin, like tetracycline, and they are obtained from the bacteria Streptomyces. So antibiotics will control the diseases in the animals and the plants also. Then we have the vaccines, which are actually the killed and weakened microbes. Killed and weakened disease causing pathogens are introduced in our body, and that is only the vaccine. When the vaccine goes inside the body, then our body releases antibodies to kill these germs that have entered with the vaccines. So when antibodies are formed, they fight and destroy the microbes. Now, while fighting, we get fever and different other symptoms. So vaccines are given so that our body develops antibodies against that particular disease, and after some time the body has its memory, and if there is a second time attack, then the symptoms and the sufferings will be quite less than the first one. So vaccines are very, very important, and they are made from the microorganisms only. Then food supplements, like, you know, there are different algae like spirulina, which are rich in protein and nutrients, so they can be used as food supplements. And in human body, this is very significant that lactobacillus is there, E. coli is there, which helps in destroying the food, destroying the other microbes, disease-causing microbes in our gut. So, see, microorganisms have various uses. Medicinal uses are also very important along with the commercial uses.